good channels. What are all they? So first one is vision, hearing, touch and movement. So first we will see the vision. Vision means we have two stages of vision. One is physical reception of stimulus and processing and interpretation of stimulus. So physical reception of stimulus, and second one is processing, reception and interpretation of stimulus. So the objectives of eye mechanism for physical reception is, so the mechanism of receiving light and transforming it into an electrical energy. Then light reflects from objects and images are focused upside down on retina, and retina contains lower light vision and cones for color vision. Then it detects pattern for the movement. So next one, so how it interpret the signal? So the size and depth of the vision is, so visual angle indicates how much of view object occupies. Then it is ability to perceive detail. The familiar object perceived as constant size. Then it overlap to help the perception of size and depth. This is the size and depth of eye vision. Then interpreting the signal, that means how the brightness and the color indicates the eye vision. So brightness means subjective reaction of levels of light. It luminance of object. Then measured by just noticeable differences. Then it indicates the luminance of eye, thus flicker. Then color indicates it made up of hue, intensity and saturation. Then cones institute to color wavelength. Then blue accuracy is lowest. So these are the eye vision of brightness and color vision. So this is one of the input channel of human. First one is eye. We have to see the eye vision. Then next one is hearing. So in hearing, we have two types, movement and change in luminance. So brightness for eye and the bright color of eye we have seen. Then next we are going to hearing, how hearing occurs. So the hearing occurs the movement and change in luminance. It used to resolve ambiguity. Then optical illusion sometimes occurs due to overcompensation. Here the illusion demonstrates our perception is size does not completely reliable. It means size does not reliable completely. So in hearing, we have the several stages. In hearing, several stages we have distances, directions, objects, etc. So in physical apparatus, we have the outer ear, middle ear, and inner ear. So outer ear protects the inner and amplifies the sound, and the middle ear transmits sound waves with vibrations to inner ear. Then inner ear reflects, chemical transmitters are released and causes impulses in auditory. So sound pictures the sound frequency, loudness for amplitude and timbre for type of quality. This is another one input channel of humans. So first one is eyesight, vision. Then second one is hearing. So third one is reading. So in reading we have several stages. Visual pattern perceived, then decoded using internal representation of languages. So interpreted using knowledge of syntax, semantics and pragmatics. So reading involves saccades and fixations. Then perception occurs during fixations. In design focus we have a word shape is important to recognition. Negative contrast improves reading from the computer screen. So this is the main the advantages of hearing. So in reading we have seen, so first one is the input channel for humans is, first one is vision, second one is hearing, third one is reading. So then the another one is touch. So in touch we have a important feedback about environment. Then it is visually impaired. So stimulus received via receptors in the skin. So thermoceptors, noiceceptors, heat and cold, all those things are we observe the touch. So some areas more sensitive than others. Example, fingers. So these is the another input channel for touch. So next one is movement. So in movement we have some recommendations using time taken for respond to stimulus, reaction time plus movement time. It will be calculated in movement. So movement time depends on age, fitness, etc. Then reaction time depend on stimulus type, both visual, auditory and pain. So increasing reaction time decreases accuracy in the unskilled operator but not in the skilled operator. This is the main advantage of movement. So in fat loss describes some formulas are calculated. So targets as large as possible, distances as small as possible. In design focus, most frequently used options can be placed closest to the user start position in the menu list. So we have many input output stages: vision, hearing, movement, touch. All those things are the main advantages we have seen in the input channels of humans. Thank you all.